Now that you've recorded your first instrument track, it's easy to build up your composition simply by adding more tracks to the arrangement. You can see the two MIDI regions that represent the drums we recorded in the last video. The track is still record enabled, so first thing is to take that out of record ready. Go to the track menu and choose new. We want another instrument track that will be placed directly below the drum track, which was selected when we created this new track. I'll flip the instrument menu and choose a new sound. An electric piano is always a favorite. Naming the track is important because you want the recorded region to bear the name of the track you're working with. Now, because the piano track is selected, I can audition simply by playing my keyboard. The reverb, a little too short, but I can edit it by clicking on the effects and choosing a different preset, maybe a small hall. Just a little bit more. Tasty. Okay, let's close the reverb and record some electric piano. Oops, forgot to record enable the track. Come over. There we go. Hit 3 to record, and off we go. Hitting the space bar will end your recording. Now, I played a wrong note somewhere in the beginning of that performance. Just there. Let's take a listen again. I can easily fix it though by choosing the hand tool and then picking the note up and transposing it to the correct note. You'll hear the note change as you move it. Now, of course, I want to repeat the piano region, but I have to trim it first, and I can do that by choosing the marquee tool, making a selection, and then hitting delete. Now just double click with the marquee tool to select the entire region, control D to make a duplicate copy. Fantastic.